Wow, that was great! So, what do you say? Another round? Maybe? Yeah, sure. That must be tiring, huh? But you did great, really. Thank you for playing with me. I'll go back to the village and tell Daddy that we're done. Just come back to the house when you're ready to hear my second wish. Hey, that was really fun, wasn't it? You'll see, in Silver Grove, it's always like that. You know, you could stay here if you'd like. I'm sure Daddy and the others would help you build a house. Oh, anyway, alrighty. As you know, I really, really love to collect butterflies. And that's my second wish. Normally, it's very... You have to search with your eyes and your ears. Just be... Here, I'll give you 15 jars. Yeah, the Moonglow Meadow. I'll wait for you in the village, just in front of the tavern. Trust me.
Madame?
You are. So have you already Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you so much. I could never have found Awesome. I knew you'd like it, and I've got something else prepared for you. Just let me take the jars back home first. See you soon. here we... Here we are. It's awesome in here, isn't it? Take a look around. So, ta-da! That's the surprise I promised you. Do you like it? It's really nice. Why? Of course me. Who else? It turned out really well, didn't it? Do you think so? I thought you'd like it, but I wasn't sure.
Can I tell you my last wish now?
I want you to stay here. I want you to stay and... I'm sure Daddy would let you move in if I ask him. It would be so great, wouldn't it?
But why not?
Why? I just don't understand. What is there in that stupid city that you need to get back to? Or is it me? It's me, isn't it? I just don't want you to leave. Without you, I'll be alone again. And I don't want to be alone anymore. Yes, I will be. There's something I need to tell you, but I'm afraid that you will hate me when I do. It's just, I don't know where to start. I never wanted them to be trapped here. You have to believe me. Back then, they were always mean to me, even though I never did anything wrong. Don't you see? Everybody hated me. They all did. And it was all just because I had those bumps on my face, and my left leg was like a big clump. Only Daddy loved me, and he... No, I never was. All this here...
Yes, one day she just fell down and died. As she walked past our house, her heart stopped beating. That's what Daddy said. But all the others said it was me. That I killed the woman with wild magic. But that's a lie. I never wanted to hurt anyone. Ever. They only said that because they hated me from the start.
No, nothing is all right.
Nothing at all. They came 2 days after that happened. It was already dark, and Daddy and I were asleep when all of a sudden they came into my room and tried to pull me out of my bed. I screamed and I cried, and then Daddy came and started screaming too and punched one of the men in the face. And then one of the women pulled a knife from her coat and she... Yes, I don't think she wanted to, but she just stabbed him in his belly again and again. And suddenly there was blood everywhere, on the floor, on my drawings, on the bed sheets, even on Thoris's basket. Then they looked at each other in a weird way and just ran. Do you understand? They just ran. Me and Daddy there. I was so afraid, sister. I was so afraid. And then the stone started speaking to me. Yes. Do you see the necklace? The stone is in there. I'm sorry I didn't tell you earlier. But I was afraid that when you found out where it was, you would just take it and leave. It said that it could make everything better. I would finally be able to walk like the others, and everyone would love me as if I were normal. What do you think? I said, yes. Then everything went black and I felt a tickle in my tummy, like when Daddy used to lift me in the air to play Myriad. It was day, and my room was so beautiful and light, and there was toys everywhere, and Daddy wasn't bleeding anymore, but was sitting on my bed. And when I did, I saw that I looked different, like the other children. Yes, and no, it's the normal world, but different. It is as I want it to be. Yes, I think that the stone can make every person here in Silver Grove see the world that I want. At first, I was so happy, you know? I was so happy. Because I found out that they were only nice to me because I want them to be. And they all just do what I want them to do, all the time. When I play tag with Gages, for example, it's not really him that I'm running from, it's me. He's just like a doll, a puppet. And everyone who comes into Silver Grove becomes like that, even if I don't want them to. But you are different. I felt it the moment Gummack let you through the gate. You see my Silver Grove? But you do what you want. I don't know, but whenever I look at you, it's like a part of you isn't really there. I know it sounds weird, but that's how it is. No, I can't. The stone, they told me once what would happen if I did. Everyone would die, because they haven't eaten anything real for years. It's only me, only my wishes that make them healthy, you see? And even if that didn't happen, I never want to go back out there. Daddy would die. That is why you have to stay. Don't you see? Please, I beg you. This is my third wish, and you promised me that you'd fulfill all of them. No, there isn't. We'd all die if I made this world go away. Why don't you believe me? There isn't. And even if there was, I wouldn't do it. You know why? Because you'd hate me out there, just like all the others. You'd see my face, the bumps, my leg, and you'd spit on me and just run away. I know you would, because it's always been like that. Always. I just can't. You say that now, but how can I know it's the truth? How can I know you won't run away when you see how I really look? Promise, but no. No, I don't believe you. And you know what? You were right. I was an idiot. I was a bad brother. But I'll do better. Not in that cold, evil world. What? No, you'd never do that. You wouldn't. The stone said you're a good person. But you can't. Wait. What is this? I feel so weird. Oh no, the stone, it's in my head. Help me, sister, help me. It hurts so much. I...
Well met.
Hey, you there. You're welcome. And may your path of...
Feel. Same shit, different smell.
Ah, Prophet. Good that you're here. Answers, I suppose. It's about the Neremese mage, Nashari. But the Entropist Sha-Rin had an idea. The word of the dead. We could use it to... well, correct. And I assume you can imagine why I am telling you this. Yes, you've already used the casket once, and you survived. That makes you the best candidate. That's the answer I was hoping for. Since Pegas' body, unlike the Pyrean, isn't preserved, we should lose as little time as possible. Who knows what the decay has already done? Very good. Then let us get right to it. I will call Sha-Rin. Well then, we are set.
I still don't understand why we aren't doing this in the Chronicum. Storage room? This is a bloody disgrace.
All the rooms in the Chronicum are occupied. Also, we don't know how the magic in the temple would react to the activation of the casket. So, if something goes wrong...
then the explosion only tears the three of us apart. How reassuring. But I get your point. Let's get started. Prophetess, open the casket. What do you think? Anything that helps us find her killer. Prophetess, did it work?
She isn't reacting. We should...
Well then, let's find the mole. All trails lead here. Still fresh. So our mole was here not too long ago. Tasty. Horror chamber. Well, well, this looks much more like a hideout, doesn't it? Traps, traps, traps. Don't want anybody to find your lair, do you? Well, too late. Would you look at that? The hideout. Let's find out who you are, shall we? What the? Naramis brandy. Didn't know you could even get that over here. These are the robes the mercenaries in Old Rashengrad wore. That doesn't really help me. An Entropis staff. So our mole is a Sinistrope. Well, well, how careless of you. Leaving a letter down here for everyone to read? Let's see. You? No, that isn't possible. All right. Upper floor, first room on the left.
Madame, how can I...
Where's the innkeep?
Running an errand. How can I help? A pint of mead or a bed?
A bed. 5 pennies, right? Here you go.
And here's the key. First room on the left. Have a great stay.
I will.
Lishari!
Not one step further.
Wait, please, I can explain everything.
Fuck your explanation! You betrayed us!
A chance, Lishari. That's all I'm asking for.
Come. Explain. You have 10 minutes.
What is it?
Huh?
You've been staring into that mug for over a minute now. What is it?
Well, let me think. I just learned that my former companion betrayed me and followed us to Enderal without my knowledge. There, he hired a mercenary army, wreaked havoc on our excavation site, destroyed my research, and massacred our allies.
I just hired them to destroy the research, dammit. Is it my fault they snapped? Also, it's godlamps they killed. The enemies we spent decades fighting, in case you forgot.
I can't stand those stuck-up idiots either, but the Lightborn are dead, and we need the Order's resources to stop the cycle. But let's skip this part, shall we? We've had that discussion before. Question is, where do we go from here?
I told you, let me go. You have my word that I won't mess with your plans any longer. If Juslan, Constantine, and you want to betray everything we stood for, it's your call. No more mercenaries, no more sabotage. There's a ship leaving for Narum in 2 weeks. Probably the last one for a long, long time. I'll be on board.
How do I know you're telling the truth? You lied for a job, Kaleem. I'm not just there.
Well, this time I'm not. Damn it, Leisha! Can't you just trust me? Just this once?
Like I trusted you with Alana.
Alright. Have it. Arrest me, throw me into a cell, and watch while the Order has me hanged. I've said everything I had to say.
Get out. Get out and never come back. And if I ever see your fucking face again, it won't be the Order who knocks your lights out.
Thanks, Leisha. I promise I...
Get out!
Farewell.
Trust me, Leisha. Thanks, Khalid. Thanks for nothing. What the...
Wake her.
Wait. Prophetess, can you hear me? By the name of the sun. So it worked. Kaleem. I should have known.
Who is this man?
A former member of our order. A master spy. He was the one who fought the hardest against Constantine's decision to join forces with Aranthiel. I always thought he stayed behind in Nerim. He and someone else, at least according to your report. Forgive me, all this... It's a lot to take in. Or maybe he's already on that ship back to Nerim. We don't know.
In other words, we're as smart as we were before.
Not entirely. I will tell Commander Aaron about all this. Maybe she'll find more clues in that theater in the Undercity. We'll see. Now, please, excuse me. I need some space. Thank you for your help, Prophet. I only wish we had learned more.
Tragic. Truly tragic. I will see to her body and ensure that she gets a proper burial. Thanks again, Prophetess. You did all you could.